After a fairly impressive first leg of his campaign trail in Ankole and Kigezi, Lieutenant General Henry Tumukunde expected a smooth sail in the Rwenzori sub-region. How wrong he was, because over the last 7 days, he hasn't faced as much resistance as he did this Monday. At Katunguru Bridge, he and the journalists on his trail were intercepted, and it took negotiation from Katwed Division Police Commander in Kasese to clear him.
All I can tell you is, like you see, I was blockaded by almost 20 vehicles, all belonging to the military, I mean to the police, and they had military, you know, the military also fully involved.
He made a stop at Kikorogo town, but even here, Uganda police presence was evident and prevented his electioneering.
I don't know if this is a campaign. I don't know if we are trying to achieve anything in this whole thing. We are simply denied. You can see them. See them. It's like a crime, a sin crime.
The situation didn't change at Kisiga town, with police advising him to divert towards Kinyamasaka in Bukonzo East till he arrived at Nyakatonzi sub-county.
What they do is that if you have got to see people on the pitch, they chase them away, they fight to direct you to the pitch, and there are no people. So we have no anything you can call. You can't even communicate your thinking to the people. We are just simply under the rough-edged handling of policemen. Actually, one policeman wanted to assault me, the young man whom I saw here now.
During mid-afternoon, he proceeded towards Kasese town, where a mammoth crowd gathered to receive him. But again, this turned futile as police intervened. His next stop was Bunyabugabo district, where he finalized what he called a hectic Monday program that he would like to forget as soon as possible and focus on the journey ahead.